morning, friends. Today we will see the projection of solid. To understand and remember various solids in these subjects properly, we should first see that the classifications of basic major two groups. Group A, which shows that the solids having the two base having the same shape, and group B, in which the solids having the one base and one is just a point as a top. It's called the apex. For one example, in the group A, let's see that it's a cylinder. We are able to see that there are the two base which are having the same shape as a circular shape. It's called the prisms also. Based on the shape of the base, the solid is classified as a triangular shape base in this figure. It's known as the triangular prism. In this figure, the square base are there, so it's called the square prism. This is the pentagonal prism. This is the hexagonal prism. And if we are having the solids which are having a six square faces, it means the length, width and height, three things are the same, then it's called the cube. In group D, let's the example as a cone which are having the circular base and at the top only the single points. This is also known as a pyramid type solids, in which there is a single base and at the top only the points. It is also classified based on the shape of the base, like these figures having the triangular base. It's called the triangular pyramids. This is the square pyramids. This is the pentagonal pyramids. And this is the hexagon pyramids. If we are having the triangular shape base and triangular faces also there, so there are the four triangular faces having the single solid. It's known as the tetrahedron. You just see that over here. This is the triangular base, same dimensions triangular, 1, 2 and 3 faces, means the four triangular faces are there. It's known as the tetrahedron. Now let's see that the dimensional parameters of these are the different solids. If we just consider over here the square prisms, square pyramids, cylinders and cones. Let's start about the square prisms. In this square prisms, this is the square pyramid, cylinders and cone. Having the different geometries are there. Let's see in the square prism, as we seen that earlier, there are the top and that is the top base. Then this is the one more characteristics having the rectangular face. Second is the longer edge. This is the corner of base. This is the edge of base. This is the bottom, or we can say that it is the base. In square pyramid, the topmost point is known as apex. This is a slant edge. This is the base. This is the edge of the base. And this is the corner of base. This is the triangular faces. And in the cylinder and cone, we are not able to visualize the slant or the vertical longer edge as we are visualized in square prism and square pyramids. So, to construct a cylinder and cone, we are required some imaginary lines to generate these curved surfaces. That is why this is called the generators. Then this is the base, same as in the prism. This is the one base and this is the top base. In cone also, the same like the square pyramid, the topmost point, it's known as the apex, and this one is the known as the base. Second is, if we just cut this cone at the incline with the base, cutting plane is inclined with the base, then we will have some shapes like this. Same thing, we just cut the cylinder by the cutting plane which is inclined with the base, then we'll have these kinds of the solid shapes. If we are having the cutting plane is inclined with the base and we just cut the square pyramids, then we'll have these kinds of the solid shape. But here we seen that these are the section of the solids in which the cutting plane is not parallel with the top or bottom or base. It means here the top base and bottom base are not parallel. See that the top base and bottom base are not parallel with each other. But here, in these two, this is the square pyramids and this is the cone. When this solid is cut by the cutting plane which is parallel with the base, then this kinds of solid is called the frustum of pyramids. This is the frustum of square pyramids and this is the frustum of cone, in which the top base and bottom base both are parallel to each other. Okay, so now let's consider as a one solid. We just consider one pyramid, and if it is resting or standing on one of the horizontal plane, and that is why if it is standing on HP, on its base, so its axis is perpendicular to HP and hence the parallel to VP. So in this case, if we just look the front view from the front side, then it will be looks like the this triangular face like this. If the pyramid is resting on one of its corner of base and axis is making some angle with the VP, sorry, not a VP, if it is making angle with the HP, axis is inclined with the HP and parallel to VP, then its front view will be looks like this kinds of the slant triangular faces. But if this solid pyramid is resting on one of its slant edge, or we can say that it is the triangular face, then it's looks like this guys. It means it is laying on HP on one of its generator line or one of its slant edge, and this axis is inclined to the HP and parallel to VP, then this solid will be considered, the front view of the solid is considered in this way. So these are the three possible positions with respect to the axis is perpendicular to HP, axis is inclined to HP, or axis is inclined to HP but it is laying on HP on one of its generator. Now let's see that if the axis is perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP, then what happened? The same kinds of the triangular shape is observed in the top view, and as we know that the top view is projected on the horizontal plane. So with respect to the XY line, the top view is drawn below XY line. So whenever the axis is perpendicular to VP and hence parallel to HP, this triangular face or the top view is projected, it's below XY line like this. Same thing, this is the standing on VP on its base and axis is perpendicular to VP and hence parallel to HP. Now the second position, if the solid is resting on VP on one of its point of base or corner of base and the axis is inclined to VP and hence parallel to HP, so this triangular shape is observed in the top view is drawn like this. Now the third one is, if the solid is lying on VP on one of its generator line and the axis is inclined to VP and parallel to HP, then this top view will be observed in this way. Okay, so these are the three positions with respect to it is standing on HP and it is standing on VP. One is it's standing on its base, second is it's standing on one of its corner, and the third one is resting on its generator or slant edge or triangular face. So these are the three possible cases can happen. Now next, These are the steps we have to follow to solve the various problems of the projection of solids. Any problems of the projection of solid problems are categorized in the step 1, step 2 and step 3 as shown in this figure. This one, first one figures. If you just see that this is the one step 1, this is the step 2 and this is the step 3. So in any problems, they are classified whether this solid having one axis which is inclined to the HP or whether it is inclined to the VP. The first step, you have to assume the solid is standing on the plane with which it is making inclination. So if the solid is inclined to the HP, then assume it's standing on the HP. And if it is inclined to the VP, then assume it is standing on the VP. So if we just consider these two cases, first one is if it is standing on HP. If it is standing on HP, then its top view will be the true shape of its base. For one example, we just consider that one of the cone. If the cone is standing on the horizontal plane, then what happen? It is the axis is perpendicular to horizontal plane. Then if we just see from the top side, then the top view will be the true shape of the base of the cone. It means it is the circle having the radius of the base of the cone. The same thing, if the solid cone is standing on vertical plane, means VP, then in that case, like this, this is the vertical plane and this is the base of the cone. This is the apex. So if we just look after from the front side, we will be able to see the true shape of this particular cone. It means its front view will be true shape of its base. Understood? So begin this kinds of the perspective. If it's a cylinder, then what happened? One true shape is the base of the true shapes. So the other view is what? If the solid is cylinder, then one of other view is a rectangular. And if it is the cone, then what happened? One is the circle, that is the one view, and the second is the triangular. Same thing for the prisms also. One is the true shape of its base and one view is looks like a rectangular. Same thing in the other pyramid, polygon, like the triangular pyramids. So the true shape is the triangular and the second one is again the triangular. If we are having the pentagon pyramids, so one view is the pentagon and the second is again the triangular. Okay, so draw the front and top view of that particular solid in the standing positions. It may happen the standing on the horizontal plane or it may happen that it is standing on vertical plane. If it is standing on horizontal plane, then the true shape of particular base of the solid will be the below xy line. And if it is tending on the VP, the true shape of the particular solid base is visualized in the top, in the front view, and it is above xy line. Okay, so this is the first steps we have completed. Now go with the second step. So now the second step, we have to draw with the consideration of the solid's inclinations. Now let's revise in our mind that this axis position is what? It's inclined with the HP or it's inclined with the VP. So based on that, now if the axis is inclined with the HP, then now initial in the step 1, we are having the top view or front view. Based on that, it is elevation or top view. The axis jiske andar aapko dikhai deta hai vertical, the height of the axis or the height of the solid jiske andar aapko dikhai deta hai, wo view ko aapko tilt karna hai. As shown in these cases, we have here, we are having the height of the solid is visualized in this view. So we have to tilt this because the axis is inclined with the HP. So the considering the solid's inclinations, particular the axis positions, and draw it the front view or top view. So this is the steps 2 is finished. Now in the step 3, there is the last steps of these problems. So in the problems, if they have just given the one more inclinations or considering the remaining inclination is given in the particular problems, you have to consider that data and draw its final front view and top view. So that is why the problems is classified in the 3 categories. One is, step 1 is the basic view of the particular solid. And the steps 2 is considering the solid's inclination. And third one is additional inclination. It means the inclinations of the edge, the inclinations of the axis with the some auxiliary planes. So here there are the different 2 case is given for the 2 different types of the solid. One is the pyramid type solids and the one is the prismatic solid. This first 2 cases is used for when the solid is inclined to the horizontal plane. And this one is the cylinder is inclined with the HP. And the next 2 figures are indicating that there are the solid is inclined, means this the cone is inclined with the VP, and here the cylinder is inclined to the VP. Okay, now let's study the next 12 problems and practice them separately. Friends, this is the engineering graphics. This subject is not to teach like a theoretical subject. To understand, to enhance the skills, you need to practice the drawing. By listening, you will be not be understand or you cannot enhance your drawing skills very quickly. So I'm suggesting you that you have to pick up any data from the subsequent slides and try to elaborate, try to summarize from that particular data, and then you have to just go through this step 1, step 2, step 3. Sequentially, then I'm confident that you will be able to solve that particular problem. So in the next lectures, we will complete that the solutions of the subsequent problems with the case studies. So thank you. If you have any doubts, if you have any queries, you just put in the comments and ask me. Definitely I will answer you. Thank you.